Sometimes I talk about this transition from the age of text to the age of knowledge. To contextualize what I'm talking about, when you look at data, information, knowledge, wisdom, there's a certain continuum that applies to this. So data, maybe the first level of the continuum, that's just scattered, uncategorized, unstructured information, right? So think about data would be, for instance, just a bunch of random names and numbers spread out somewhere, right? If you organize that data and you turn it into information, that's a phone book, right? Now all of the names, maybe they're in alphabetical order and they're side by side with the numbers. So you go from data to information, right? And it's pretty clear that we're well into and past the idea of information. Now when you go to knowledge, now it's the ability to retrieve exactly what you need and to understand what you're trying to accomplish, right? So the idea of knowledge is that now there are goals. It's not just about, let's say, fact. It's the difference between fact and knowledge is one thing is knowing that, let's say, and the name of a country is X. The knowledge about that country is maybe that living in that country doesn't feel that good because of this reason, or it feels amazing because of that reason, or that you should actually leave early in order to get there on time because you know that if you don't, you're going to get more traffic. So it involves taking in a lot of information, so not just data, structured data as in the form of information, and generating parallels and insights across that information so that you can make informed decisions, right? So when I talk about this transition from the age of text to the age of knowledge, we're talking about, in the age of text, we're talking about things that are structured, like, for instance, okay, you translate in an editor and you're storing things in the translation memory and you're storing things in the glossary. That's all information, right? It's just like the phone book. But it's not that easy to find things in the phone book. So when you're translating, and let's say you want to check how a certain thing is translated, you have to go in and search the translation memory. It's like opening up the phone book and looking for a particular name and seeing what the number is under that name and then going back. So there's a lot of searching, a lot of cross-referencing. So that's what I call the age of text, right? You're looking at text, you're still burdening the human to create any kind of actual knowledge out of that text, right? The translation memory won't know, let's say, for instance, that the glossary is diverging from it, and maybe can alert that, but it won't be able to merge those things together, won't be able to make something out of it, right? So when you go into, let's say, vectorized, tokenized information, then it becomes easier to talk about knowledge because it becomes easier to cross-reference lots of very different kinds of information sources and make informed decisions based on those things. So that's where I think we're at kind of right now. We're getting into this, we're getting deeper into this age of knowledge, right? Now, the next step, and I don't know if that next step is compatible with human nature, is the age of wisdom, which is a whole other level of knowledge. It's when you actually know things at a much deeper level and you're able to make just the right, you know, just a good example of this, like the difference of knowledge and wisdom, right? If you're thinking about, okay, leaving early, right? You want to get to the beach, and you know that if you leave early, there's a greater probability that you won't get traffic, and there's a greater probability that you'll make it sooner to the beach. Cool, that's knowledge. Wisdom maybe comes from having gone to the beach 100 times over the past 10 years, and realizing that even though you feel tempted to go to the beach, you're actually going to be a lot more relaxed and at ease Sunday night if you stay home, right? So that's the difference, right? You're taking in a ton of knowledge over a span of time, over a continuum of information, and making deeper inferences, right? That's wisdom, right? It's what is wise to do. What would be the most appropriate? It's being able to select the most appropriate path for a given outcome. That's what I would call wisdom. So, and broader outcomes, right? So again, I would say knowledge, narrower outcomes. So for instance, how do I get to the beach? Best way, that would be knowledge. But the wisdom would be, you know, even reflecting on the question, should I be going to the beach? and when should I be going? How often should I be going? How long should I be staying? Those are decisions that often involve wisdom and not just knowledge. So we're definitely not there, in my opinion, as far as knowledge when we come to technology and where our space is, but we are in this space of we're definitely not there in terms of wisdom, but we're definitely in this moving towards this space of knowledge, right? And what that means for the industry and translators is that now there's actually a lot more burden to do something with this knowledge, right? So now if you know that, let's say, using this term will result in higher indexation. Let's say a good example, right? Let's say you're translating the idea of translation and localization. A lot of countries don't have this idea of localization in their language. So now you have to make a decision. Are you going to find an alternative term for localization? Are you going to just translate everything as translation? And now, instead of having translation and localization, you're just going to index for translation? That could be. Those are decisions that involve certain level of knowledge around search engine optimization, around the product, around the brand, around the audience. So that is where I believe that we're moving into. It's being able to make these decisions that require cross-referencing much more information and building this into knowledge. And that's where the agents come in too, because if you don't have agents that are telling you these things, that are informing you these things, that are structuring these different aspects that you could be looking at, it's very difficult for a single person to cross-reference all of this data, right? So I think when you have agents that are facilitating that, then it becomes a lot more simple for people to make these complex decisions. And these are micro decisions. Hundreds of them need to be made every single day, right? These are little editorial decisions that have a ton of impact. And then eventually, these insights will get better and better, where we're actually going to get the agent's wisdom as opposed to just knowledge. So I think that's overall what I mean by leaving the age of text and going to the age of wisdom, of knowledge first, eventually, maybe, who knows, wisdom.